Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to look into one of the components of English words language, which is grammar, WH words and WH questions. Now we look at the questioning techniques, right? There are two main types of questioning techniques, which are yes or no questioning technique and WH questioning technique. The yes or no questions are the simple ones. The answers expected out of these questions asked are literally a yes or a no. It can be as simple as, have you eaten? The answer expected out of that would be yes, I've eaten, or no, I've eaten. A simple answer as yes to the question or no to the question would be enough. However, WH questions include words which are used to ask about specific qualities, times, places, people, and so on. WH questions cannot have a yes or a no as an answer. Now, before using the WH questioning technique, students should be well versed on the WH words. Students are supposed to know what type of words are to be used for what reason. We look at the first one. The word what, they are used to talk about things. When are used to talk about time in specific. Where used to talk about a place where something happened. Who used to talk about people. Which used to talk about choices that they have. Who's used to talk about possessions or belongings. Why used to talk about reasons or causes of something. While how used to talk about manner or process in which something happened. We look at WH questions now. How to form these WH questions? Okay, it will start with the WH word itself. We are going to add with the auxiliary word and then subject, verb, followed by the object if it's there. We look at the first example. What did you eat this morning? If I were to divide it into all the parts equally, the WH word in this sentence would be what, auxiliary word would be did, subject would be you, verb would be eat, and object is this morning. So whenever we look at this whole thing as a sentence, this makes up a WH question. Same goes for the second example. When is she coming to school? When would represent the WH word, is would represent the auxiliary word, she is the subject here, coming is the verb, while object is to school. Next part. WH word would be which one, auxiliary word would be do, subject would be you, verb would be prefer. Which one do you prefer? It makes up a perfect sentence which has the WH word as a starter. So when we look at these sentences separately, what did you eat this morning? I cannot answer yes to this question, nor can I answer no to this question. Therefore, a WH question requires a specific answer to it. What did you eat this morning? It can be as simple as I had a toast with scrambled eggs this morning. It requires a specific information. When is she coming to school? She's coming to school at 5, let's say. I cannot answer yes, nor can I answer no to this question. The same goes to, which one do you prefer? I prefer the red one over the blue one. I have to give a specific information to what the question is asking. Again, a WH question is not the same as yes or no. Yes or no is as simple as giving a positive or a negative answer, whereby WH questions are asked to specify, to get a specific answer. That's all for today. Thank you and keep practicing your WH questions.